So you join me back at the car. I've had a little bit of a tidy out, lost the car today. So I've lost the car, gained a little bit more space in the workshop. So what I'm gonna do today is just finish off this front end. What we've been doing on the front end is we've got the headlight wires. So there's the three headlight wires, which is, I'm on the driver's side, or the UK driver's side. So I've got these three headlight wires, white, red, and red, yellow. So I've got white, red, red, yellow. They're the three for the headlight, and there's a little mod in the manual. I've also got green, black, which green, black, as you know, indicator, green, white is right, green, black is left. So green, black's actually going to go that way with the rest of this junk here. But what you should be able to see now, green, white. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a six-way connector in here. Now in the manual, I've just updated it as well, especially for this. What I've done is in the manual, there are certain pin numbers. I'll flash up the pin number wiring on the screen, but what I shall do is I'm gonna wire this to the pin numbers. It's gonna make our lives really, really easy. If everybody wires it to the pin numbers that I put in the manual, then on both sides, it's gonna be incredibly easy to debug in future. I've got an earth here as well, which is gonna go to a sort of multi-joint about here, and then it's gonna come back on itself. I need an earth for the indicator. I need an earth for the headlight, a side light in the headlight. Not for the main lights. So, and I also am gonna put a plug up about here. I'm gonna put one plug here for the six-way plug just here. And then about here, I'm gonna put a four-way plug, which is gonna be used for the nose cone indicators. So, right, let's get cracking. So I've got a better view of where I'm and what I'm doing at the moment. So I just need to get, first of all, these three wires here and cut them to length, cut them to suitable length. So that is the, oh gosh, it's tight. Blimey, blimey. So you've got red, orange, or red, yellow, red and white. So these are the headlight connections. Now this is all pretty basic stuff. All I'm gonna be doing here is putting, this is a connector. This is what we call a conoseal style connector. It's pretty much what most, manufacturers use. So I'm gonna put always, the male goes on the item and the female goes on the car. So let's just strip this back and show you how it works. And then I'm gonna put the ends on. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the locations of where they need to go. Now, and I'll get the locations and then I'll just punch them into the plug in the same location as per the manual. I wanna really hit that home about the manual because it's gonna be so beneficial to everybody. These are just crimp connectors. So I've got a little gadget here. Hopefully you can see that. And all we're doing is just literally just pushing the wire home and then crimping it. I mean, it takes seconds to do, look at that. So it doesn't take very long to do at all. That's why I kind of like using them. Now these wires are getting consistently thicker as we go down this this list of wires that we need to crimp. And they're noticeably thicker. That one is beefy, real beefy. I don't know if that's a bit too thick for the, I mean obviously it's part of the loom, but it's a little bit on the thick side for this particular car, I think. For these particular headlights. Obviously it's used to dealing with the Mazda headlights, so we're gonna need to just make sure it's all hunky-dory. See, they've gone in all right. This is the last one. This is gonna be a bit of a challenge. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get this rubber over the top. These are like watertight rubbers. No, it's not gonna go. Oh, or is it? Gosh. Gosh, that's tight. I don't know whether we're gonna be able to use that at the other end, but Well, it's on. Look. That is one thick, beefy, thick cable on the tool that I've got. And incidentally, just so you know how to do this. So what I tend to do, take this in my left hand. I shoot it up to the first click. Hear that snap? So that's now kept into the tool. And then I just poke the wire through, as you've probably seen. Once you poke the wire through, just give her a squeeze. Job done. That's it. I mean, literally, that is it. So there's those three. Now what I've got to do is get the pinouts of this. Now in the manual, it shows facing. So all the pinouts are all done facing this plug, facing the plug. So all they do is they just fit in there like that, bosh. Right, let's get the pinouts. Okay, so I've got the pin numbers. So this is the plug, and I'm gonna start with the indicator one, which you didn't see me put on because I just did it off camera. That's pin 6. So that'll go into pin 6. Literally, if you listen for the click, in that click, that's seated that home. So pin 6 is the indicator. Now the reason why I've left this nice and long is because it's going to go up there and it's going to loop out of this other plug that I've got there. So I'll come back to that one in a minute. Then I've got, I need an earth, which is going to go to my black sort of junction point there. So I need to just grab a spare bit of black cable. But maybe that'll do. That'll be all right. And I'll pop an end on that. I think pin 1 is the earth. I'm gonna cut in and out of this because I've literally just done the pin outs. So I'm gonna need to read them, and I'm actually needing my phone that I'm doing the recording on to look at the pictures that I've got. So, but I'll put the black, I think between us, we should have almost enough. The only other one, so there's the black, which I'm doing. And there's one more, which is the side light. So there's me black. Okay, that's fine. And the side light is that plug there, or that one there. Again, that's going to go up there, multi-joint, and come back on itself because it's got to go around to the other side as well. So I'm going to I'll multi-joint that up just about here. What I'll do for the minute is I'll just pop an end on here. I'll pop an end on this one. And then that's enough then for us to basically put that plug together. Right, so I've got all my plugs that I need, all my cables, whatever. Now I just need to get them seated into this connector right here, and then I can start doing something with the loom. Right, let me get these pinouts. Right, so I've now got these plugged in the correct location, they are as per the manual there. So then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fit this part of the plug. So they're all in, they've all clicked in, plug that in. That is a job done. Now all I need to do is just tidy this so that the wires go the right way. So what I've got here, look, is, and what I am gonna do, I'm just gonna go and get a bit of tape and put a bit of tape around that, just to tidy that little up. But that's basically what you're aiming at, is to get that out of the loom there. So that will all go in split conduit. So there's your out. I'll get even flashy and I'll just put this around here. There's your out for the headlight on this side. That will come up through there. So what we'll do now is we'll create the indicator. So there's a 4-block indicator there. Again, that is in the manual, the pinouts. So what I need here is a red black. Now, I've got 2 red blacks in this loom. So I need a red black. I need a red. I need 2 blacks. That's going to go down to my multi-joint. That can keep going round there, because that's going to be jointed. I could theoretically double that up and put that into the socket down there. So I might even do that. It's just a bit harder when you're putting 2 wires into one of these little plugs, that's all. That's why I like to sort of do a multi-joint. So again, this is going to be a 4-way connector, right? And it's about where the chassis number stamped on the car. It's going to go in about there, so you can just about get to it. This particular green-black, which is the right left-hand indicator, green-black. Now, I've got a spare one that runs around over there. So with green-black, you're all right to cut that. You don't need that. What we need to do with green-white is do a joint down there and then bring one back up. So I'm going to do the joint alongside where the black lives. So I'm going to stagger the joints though. I'm going to do the blacks further round. And the reason is so I can get it in the split conduit. I just need to make sure that I've got the right one of these. That there needs to go to be cut there. I need to put another end on that there. I need to put an end on that there. And what I'm trying to do is I need to stagger the joints, as I said, so that there's not too much in the split conduit. So what I'm intending to do, look, I'm going to run that down to there, cut that off because it's only a little tiddler, join them together, loop that out and back again and join that lot together, and we should be happy days then. And then the whole lot should work quite merrily. So if I strip them 2 back, that's going to go down, come back on itself, look, and then be joined to that. I need a bit of heat shrink. Better power the old soldering iron up, hadn't I? A bit of heat shrink, power up the iron. We should be away. While waiting for the soldering iron to warm up, I've got some black wire here. What I'm going to do is sort of get crazy together here. So I'm going to run the black. It's going to go up one solid line that goes to the main earth point of the car. I don't like putting earths all over the car, because if you get an earthing problem, you just got nowhere to start. You got so many different places. So that's a little hot tip for you there. Put in the manual this 4-way plug. So this is a 4-way plug. Econoseal plug, and I've put in there where this one goes, what the pinouts are for this particular plug as well. So I'm trying to make it so that it's all documented, so that we know exactly where to put stuff, just so that debugging it at a later date is a lot easier. First click grips the tool, so I'm just going to solder that and that together. I've already got my heat shrink on, so all I now need to do is just hold that on there. So that's your signal wire splitting into 2. using these terminals makes it a very quick process. I mean, I'm going quite slow at the moment. Because every time they just crimp up so lovely. They really do. Now all I need to do is get the pinouts. So I've just put the first one in, pin 3, green, white. Pin 4, green, black. And then the other two, Herberts, 1 and 2, are both blacks. Both black cable. So that's quite good. So there's my black cable. Put them in there. Now it doesn't matter which way around they go, because they're both going to be joined down the bottom here, so it matters not. There we go, all in, all done. So I'm going to do the same as I did there with those three. I'm going to take that together. Oh, I've got to put a seat in it. Let me put a yellow seat in there first. There's your yellow plug. So let me just stick a lump of tape around that. I mean, basically, that's all I'm trying to do. I've done it a 3-pin and a 4-pin. I've done it a 6-pin and a 4-pin. So you can't put the wrong thing in the wrong one. You can only put it together one way round. I mean, what a super job he's done there. So that's going to sit in there quite nicely. What you can do as well, this will be quite useful. So you've got an out for the fan. So the fan normally comes out in the middle. So I'm going to just get these together. About there is the middle. So there's the fan breakout. It's going to be there. I need to do something with these black cables. So what I think I'm going to do, where the fan breakout is there, I need to break these two out, hook them into the main earth that we've got there, hook the other bit into the main earth. I just got to hook the earths together, really. So I might just do that here, because there's not a lot going on. So if I do it underneath where the chassis number is, starters for 10, we're going to go here. Let's go a little bit further along, about there. That'll do. So all I'm going to do is just tackle this lot together. Then once all this lot is together, we can then tack it into the main line. I've got to send another two that way. Two earths. But it'll be fine. So I'll strip them back. I'll put the iron on back on because I think I'm going to start tacking these together. So there's three. There's going to be another one coming in. I mean, this is going to be a big lump here. I'm going to wrap all that lot together, blob a bit of solder on it, get a bit of a big old fat lump of heat shrink, and take the other three the other way, solder the whole lot together. So I've got those three there, and then I'm just going to make that headlight and the fan. There's my massive earth multi-joint. That'll do. She's in. Cover that up. I did make a mercy dash to the office, and I have got now some split conduit, which is always a bonus. Right, let me heat shrink that. So all of this lot's going to sit inside split conduit as well, which is giving it that extra level of protection. Get that. I need a breakout. I need a break. So my black and my yellow wire is take those two out. They're going to come out and be, I don't know, say that long. That'll do. So let's cut them to length. Give that a bit more length so that that can plug into there quite handsomely. What I haven't got at the moment is a two-way plug that goes in there. I've only got a four-way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to unpick that and put the two-way link in there. What we're going to do, I'm going to put some of this sheathing over the end. Now, yes, I could have done the other ones like that, but I haven't. I didn't. I'm only doing this because it's a bit longer. I could put loom tape on it. There's several different ways of skinning a cat. Okay, so that's poking through. I've got one at either end. All I'm going to do is poke my wires through. Now, these have got tangled inside. They don't go together very well. Okay, they've popped out the top, look. So what I'll do now is just heat shrink that there and heat shrink that at the bottom. Well, I'm going to put the two terminals on the end first. So they're the opposite of those. So that's a male. I'm going to put two females on the end of there. Unpick the plug. I'll even show you how to unpick the plug as well. Right, again, I can use my little blue tool. Put it in the biggest one. It's quite versatile, this tool, actually, to be fair. I'll have my finger back, though. Ah! They're going to go into the plug, which I've got somewhere. What did I do with that? I'm just going to put me the side. Literally, I'm only using a four-way because I haven't got any two-ways left. I've got to get some more. So I'm going to pull that there. Slap a bit of heat onto that. That should shrink that. The other end. Now, how good a job does that look? That looks pucker. That looks like it's been done in a factory, doesn't it? That looks absolutely pucker. So that... Oh, bother. Let me unpin them. I'm going to put them into the right... What you do to unpin them... Now, in there, there's a little tab. All you do is you just push the tab down. Push the tab down, and it should come out. So you can see the little tabs in there. There you go. How about that? So to get it back together again, what you do is you lift the tabs back up, making sure you don't stab yourself in the finger. Push the tabs back through. So you've got two little tabs there now. And then all you do, make sure that that plugs into there. And I've got my blue, which is that one there. So blue to yellow, black to black. And if it spins the wrong way, you just swap these two over. So that loom is now going to come round there. It's going to come up over the top. There we go. Yeah, home and dry. How about it? I'm just going to pop a tie wrap on that there, that piece of the loom, just so it stays in situ. That will need to be tie wrapped also around. Oh, you can't see that. This will need to be tie wrapped around the fan so that it doesn't get jammed in any suspension or anything like that. Based upon the other one sort of finished about there, so I think we'll do the same thing. We'll cut these down to there. Brown needs to tee out, and that's not included. That is for the horn, that's correct. I don't need that just yet. I need to tee those two together. I'm going to tee the horn out because the horn sits about here. But I've got a green, black, red, indicator, white. So they're all going into this little plug that sits on the end here. So I'm going to cut them there and they will all go into a plug. All right, so I get all of those into a six-way plug. Get these in the plug, these five, and then I'll do the side light wire in a minute. Remember from earlier, these wires are the ones we extended down over just where the inlet manifold is. Six-way plug. with the catch at the top. That one there, I think it's pin five, you know. Pin four. Yeah, that's pin four. Pin four is white. The reason why I've done this plug and I'm working to the plug pinouts is because our MK loom that we've built and designed is exactly the same. So theoretically, you could upgrade to the MK loom and your headlights would not need any changing other than literally unplugging a plug and plugging another one in. So that's pin, that's plug six. Six is fine. I know one is black. I think red's in three. Side light is in, yeah, that's fine. Thick red. Side light we'll come back to, that leaves the green one right at the bottom. So it's all pretty basic stuff. Right, let's do something with this. So what I'm gonna do is cut it here. Cut it here. Cut it there. Oh, hang on, let's get that round the right way. It's gonna come round there. Cut it there, cut it there. Join them two together. And then run that one into there. Job done. Heat gun. Drop a bit of heat on it. My gun is the Bosch PHG 500-2. It's about the right place, isn't it? About there. Strip that wire back, look. So if I now put that last one in there, we should be all good. Just clipped in to put the faceplate on, and that's it. Now the reason why I'm using these Econosil connectors is quite simply because if you do, the headlights come with Econosil connectors on it. I'm going to leave this for the moment because I don't know what we've got in the way of the hooter. So I'm just going to cut it off about here. Got to get the hooter. So I can come back to the hooter anyway. But that's a final finish on the loom there. I mean, that's pretty good. That fits in the right places. All the right places. What we can do is get the plug and start plugging in. But I need to go back to the manual on that because there is a specific, and we do need to run another wire. If you look in the manual, they'll tell you how to do it. But that is front loom, bird's nest, done. I'll tell you what I'll do, I'll put it in split conduit now. And I'll measure out how much split conduit you need. So from there, round to there. 2.1 metres of split conduit in the front loom. Right, what we'll do now, I'm going to split conduit this front loom. Then I'm going to tie wrap it in, and then it's done. plug the fan in. I am going to do now another tie wrap, just to tie wrap that up and out of the way, just to be cautious, really. Let me just be cautious and put that out of the way. I don't want it getting caught in the rockers. So we've gone from bird's nest to nice fancy looking loom. Look at that. They're all in split conduit there, runs round there in front, underneath the chassis rail there. We've got the output for the right hand headlight, for the nose cone indicators. In there, there's an indicator as well. We've got the nose cone indicators. It runs under the V. We've got an output for the fan in the sexy braided motorsport. I don't know what you call that, like a sheath. Then it runs out, and then we've got another out here for the other headlight. So that is your, that is taming of the loom, the front loom, complete. Done. Now we just got to do the front to back and the back loom. Oh, well, there are some other bits we need to do. So what we've got here, this side, is we're running the pots on this one. So we need to take the, we need to do the brake light switch, and we need to do the pots, which is, the pots are very, very straightforward. I'll show you how to do those in the next episode.